Hello, my children of KJA. You must welcome this lesson, Teacher Tongu Sura. I want to be very ready for this lesson because if we're not ready, we're not getting what we're going to discuss today. So you're welcome. Today we're going to discuss bases. Bases, this is not a new thing to you, my good boys. We started this one in primary 5, so I'm going to just review what we discussed in primary 5, then we go to primary 6 work. As we continue, my good boys and girls, I'll pose a question to you. Question number 1, what are bases? That is very important. If you don't know what we're going to discuss, you will not learn it. So the first question is, what are bases? If I can give you a definition, I know we talked about this in primary 5, but bases are a system of counting in groups. So when you group things together, for example, groups of 2s, groups of 5s, groups of 7s, so we were dealing with something called bases. Good. After knowing that, my good boys and girls, there are 2 categories of bases. There are 2 groups of bases. There are 2 categories of bases. So we can say bases are categorized. My good boys, these are the 2 categories of bases. We have got decimal bases and non-decimal bases. So, point number 3, my good boys, we have to know. We have discussed what about decimal bases. Decimal base is a system of counting in tens. The grouping, the counting of things in tens is what we call decimal base. For example, when you get mangoes and put them in groups of tens, you get passion fruits, put them in groups of tens, you get pears, put them in pairs of tens. So those are what we call, that's what we call a decimal base. Okay. My good boys, come to have note about decimal base. There are other names for decimal base. So we shall say decimal base can also be called, my good children, decimal base can also be called standard base. If you don't call it standard base, my boys and girls, it can also be called dinary base. Decimal base can also be called standard base or dinary base. You must be very careful here because examiners would wish to use one of these 2 words to mean decimal base. So you must know these 2 words because at times they are used when they are setting some questions. Good boys. Okay, let's move on. We are still under decimal base, my good boys and girls. Boys do not. What are the digits in base 10? We have seen bases are categorized into two, namely decimal base and non-decimal bases. Point number next, I talked about decimal base is a system of counting in tens. For example, I have my straws here, my boys. When we group these straws in tens, that is called base 10. Let's go, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8,
10. So we have grouped these straws in 10. So this is what we call verse 10. That is one. I have my books, my good boys and girls. Look at these books. These are books. But we want to make 10, what make books? 10 books in a group. So we say that is verse 10. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is a group of 10 books. To me, this is now verse 10. We can also move to the example. We have markers here, my boys. These markers are used for writing. When teachers are making their charts, they use these markers to write on the charts. We can also have a group of 10 markers. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is a group of 10 markers. So we have, this is verse 10. So my good boys, that is what you call decimal base. And we have said, ladies, my good boys, that decimal base can also be called standard base. Can also be called denale base. These two words are key words when they are setting examination. We are going to see them later on. But my good boys and girls, you must know the two words to mean base 10, to mean decimal system. Okay? That is okay. Then you move to something else. We want to know the digits which are in base 10. The digits in the following digits. Base 10 uses the following digits. First digit is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are digits used in base 10. There's a law in base which says we are not supposed to write any digit which is equal or bigger than that base. So, my good boys, these are digits which are used in verse 10. Okay. After knowing that, talking about decimal bases, now we go to non-decimal bases. Non-decimal system is the system of counting in other bases other than base 10. My good boys of Jitan and Nigeria, look here. Non-decimal system is a system of counting other bases other than base 10. So other bases, other counting, other groupings of objects apart from base 10 is what we call non-decimal system. Now, ladies, my good boys, let's look at examples. Examples of non-decimal system of counting. Let us look at other examples, my good boys. We talked about some of them, but we didn't know where they belong, so they belong here. So look at our chart here. These are examples of non-decimal bases. Now the first one is base 2. Another name is called binary base. If you look at this table, it has got the base, another name, and the digits used. So now we have solved your work here. We have put everything together in one table. So we have bases, we have another name for those bases, and we have the digits that they use. So look here, my good boys and girls. So we are saying that base 2, that is another thing called binary base. The grouping of objects in base 2 is what we call binary. I have my straws, my good boys and girls. We have my straw. These are straws. But when you group objects in twos, when you group objects in twos, so this system called binary system. So what digits they use? They use 0 and 1. We are not supposed to write any digit which is equal or bigger than. That's why you see this 1 is less than 2, because those are the two digits. So that base is called base 2. Another non-decimal is called base 3. Then that's called ternary system. Ternary system. So this is another name for base 3. When you group things in threes, when you group things in objects in threes, in threes, in threes, in threes, the group objects in threes. So this is called base 3. That another one, before that there is another thing it's used in base 3. We have 0, 1, and 2. You cannot see 3 here. Why? Because the system says we're not supposed to write any digit which is equal or bigger than that base. So we don't have 3 here. So there are only 3 digits used in base 3. Another one is base 4. That is called quaternary base. Quaternary, this is base 4. Quaternary is another name for base 4. So when you group things in fours, when you group things in fours, objects have my straws. I'm grouping these straws in fours. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is one group of fours. Then I have another one. 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I may use one of these two groups, these are two groups of fours. Then after the grouping of these straws in fours is what we call base 4. Good. So what kind of thing is used in this 4? We have 0, 1, 2, 3. We cannot have 4 here as we have said. Because 4 is bigger than, 4 is equal to 4. So we cannot have 4 in that. Good. Another one is base 5. Base 5. Another one is called quinary base. Quinary base. This is another name for base 5. So when you group objects in 5s, this is what we call base 5. So I have my straw. I have my straw. Now let's start. Let me use my markers now. I have my markers here. I have my markers. I have some in reach. I have some objects here. I'm green. So they have markers. So we are going to go in 5. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is one group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are two groups of 5s. So what do we say? Groups of 5. So that is what we call best 5, because we have grouped objects in 5s. So what I think is my good boys and girls? We have 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. You cannot have 5 as we say, because we cannot write that thing which is equal or bigger than that thing that base 5 is. So, okay, let's move on to another example, base 6. Base 6. Another name called scenario base. Scenario base. Scenario base. The system of grouping objects in 6s is what we call base 5. Or you can call it quinary base. Okay? Now I have my straw. So we are grouping objects in 6s. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 1. I can put it here. Another one, let's go. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let me put this one here now. So I have got 6 groups. This is 2. These are 2 groups of 6s. Are we together? Yes. So the grouping of the thing objects in 6s in six is what we call synally base or base six. Good. Okay. Another one is base seven. Another one is called septenary base. So this is have 0 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Another one is 8. When you group objects in eight, that base is called octo base. Or you can call it base 8. What are the digits in base 8, my good boys and girls? We have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So we cannot have a digit bigger than 7 because that is the law which governs bases. Another one is base 9. Base 9, you can call it nonary base. Nonary base is the system of grouping objects in nines. The system of grouping objects in nines is what we call nonary base or base 9. What are the digits? Look here, my boys. Look here, don't sleep. Look here. We have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8. These are the digits in base 9. So the system of grouping objects, the system of grouping objects in 9 is what we call base 9 or nonary system of counting. So my good boys, these are the examples of non-decimal system of counting. These are what we call the examples. Now, there's a note on my chart here. All bases have the number of digits equal to the base itself. We have this note. We are reading as we're reading as well. All bases have the number of digits equal to the base itself. What does it mean, my boys and girls? That if you look at base 2, because of 2, we have only 2 digits, 1 and 2. As simple as that. Base 3. Digits in 3 must be only 3. What are those? 0, 1, 2. Base 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Base 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Base 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Base 7, and base 8, and base 9. So my boys who there who are watching me, I'm telling you that you cannot have the number of digits which is higher than the base itself. Okay? So this is that is a summary of bases. Now today, let's look at place values of bases. After we have known the categories of bases, my boys and girls, we have known the examples of the non-decimal bases. Now we are going to look at place values of bases. Just like in whole numbers, we look at numbers, we talked about place values, the positions of numbers, the position of digits in the number. That's what we call place values. Now we also want to look at place values of bases. But we have to note something, my good boys and girls out there, that place values of bases are developed from their powers. This is technical. You must know this. The place values of bases are developed from their powers. For example, look here, my good boys and girls out there. Look here. Examples. Let's look at base 2. Base 2. Place values of base 2. Place values of base 2. We have said place values of blessings are developed from their powers, are God from their powers. Now look here, if you want to get place values of base 2, we are using powers of 2. So we have 2 to the power 0. 2 to the power 0, my good boys and girls, that's what you have to know here, that any number to power 0 is 1. Any number to power 0 is 1. Any number to power 0 is 1. So 2 to the power 0 is 1. Therefore, here we shall get 1, which equal to our 1s as the place value. Look here. 2 to the power 0 is equal to 1, which is equal to 1s. Now let's go here. My good boy is 2 to the power 1. 2 to the power 1 is any number to power 1 is the number itself. 2 to the power 1 is that number, is the number itself. Therefore, 2 to the power 1 is equal to 2. So the place value becomes 2s. Are we together? Yes, let's move on to the another one. 2 to the power 2. My good boys, this one is equal to, these are 2 groups of 2s. 2 groups of 2s. 2 groups of 2s. So these are 2 2s. Have 2 2s. How do we get that? Yes. Now look here. We got the third one. I'm going to stop on the third one, then add on in your free time. So we have 3 2 to the power 3, which is equal. These are 3 groups of 2s. Remember your P1, P2. 3 groups of 2s, which is 2 times 2 times 2. Now, these are 1, 2, these are 1, 2, 3. So this becomes 2, 2, 2s. So that is. I want in your free time, my good boys, to add on 4 and give me, add on and give me, because this is supposed to be 4 groups of 2s. I want to see here and then give me that position, that place value of that. So these are place values of 2s. The first one is 1s. 2s. 2 2s. 2 2 2s. So this is how place values are developed. Okay. From there, let's go and have another example. Let's have another example. Base 2. Now let's go to our friend in base 5. I'm skipping base 3 and base 4. Because that is your homework. I want you to develop the powers of base 3 and base 4. Now let us look at this verse in primary 5. So we have said, don't remember that place values are developed from the powers. For example, we have 5. So we shall have 5 to the power 0. My good boys have said 5 to the power 0. Any number to the power 0 is 1. Therefore, this one is 1. Now, what is the place value in 1 that is 1s? Have you seen? Now, let's go. The letter 1, 5 to the power 1. Any number to power 1 is the number itself. I'm repeating, those are those things. Any number to power 1 is that number. Therefore, this I have 5. Now, this place value becomes 5s. Have you seen that? Now look here, another one is 5 to the power 2. These are 2 groups of 5s. Have you seen that? 2 groups of 5. So we shall have 5 times 5. So what do I have here? I have 5, the place value becomes 5 5s. Okay. I know you are getting the skill. Now let us look at this one. 5 to the power 3. These are 3 groups of 5s. So what do I have? 5 times 5 times 5. And what becomes the place value then? It becomes 5 5 5s. So have you seen that? Now this is your homework, my good boys. So develop for me that. So that becomes 5 5 5 5s. 5 5 5. Once again, 5 5 5s. So That those are the place values. So I want you to devote for me this one, which comes from 5 to about power 4, and give me the answer here, and instead of giving the answer there. So that is how we develop powers of the bases. I hope and I know from these two examples, you can sit down and develop those one of base 6, base 7, base 8, base 9. From your free time, please do that so you can develop the skill. Lastly, let's go to our new examples now, how the questions are set. Examples, how questions are set. They can set for you, they cannot set for you this. This is just you are being developing the present, but they can set for you this. But they are going to say how questions are set from base values. Question 1 says, find the place values of each digit in the numbers below. Keyword, place value. Always understand the keyword is the question. At times you misfire and ask place value and give value, so take note of that question. At times they use another word called numerals, and then you get confused. Numerals means numbers. Okay. What is our first numeral, first number? 1, 2, 3, base 5. So these are powers of 5. Place values of 5s. So we are going to see 1, 2, 3. So here we shall have 1s. As we have seen, 5 to the power 0 is 1s. So we have 5 to the power 1. Remember to say 5 to the power 1 is 5s. Remember we have said that place values are developed and got from the powers. So here what we have, 5 to the power 2, which becomes 5 5s. So you have answered that question when you give such an answer. Okay? Good boys, this is the answer. Because they have told us find a place value of each. I know my children, some of them you are lazy. You will find only one and then you stop, but you are missing some marks. Each. So it means that you have to place value of each digit in this number. So that's example number 1. Example number 2, and this is the last one. Then we shall have our activity. Okay? Part B. We have 1, 4, 3, 2, base 6. The question, don't forget our question. Find the place values of each digit. So we have to look for the position. Remember, place means position. So we are going to see. So we are going to use our place value arrows. 1, 4, 3, 2, base 6. Okay. Remember, we say that the place values are developed from their powers. Powers of 6. Okay. This is 6 to the power 0. We say 6 to the power, any number to the power 0 is 1. Yet we have 1s. Okay. Next one. 6 to the power 1. 6 to the power 1. Remember, we say a number to power 1 is that number itself. So the first become 6s. Hey, 6s. Remember, look at the single digit. S must be there. Single digit. Okay. This one we come to 6 to the power 2, which becomes 2 groups of 6. It becomes 6 6s. Okay, good. The last one. Someone is dozing, not dozing. Okay, last one. This is 6 to the power power three. Those are three groups of six. So shall have six, six, sixes. So this is how we get the place values of digits in the numerals. So my good boys, after discussing all of that, I think you have got, we began, so from the other side up to this end, up here. Now you can go through before I give you my activity. So those are the place values of places. Activity. Activity now. Activity. So don't copy someone, don't call mommy to help you, don't call CBT. There are only two numbers. The first two are say the first number. Write down the first four. Write down the first four place values. Write down the first four place values in the following bases. In the following bases. Write down the first four place values in the following bases. Part A, base 3. Base 3. Part B, base 4. Base 4. Part C, septenally. Let me talk about this word, septenally. This is base 7. Number 2. Write the place values. Write the place values of each digit. Of each digit in the numerals. In the numerals below. Don't forget that this is what numerals mean, numbers. So we have 1 1 1 0 base 2. Part B, 1 2 1 base 3. Part C, 1 3 2 base 5. And lastly, part D, 1 4 5 base 7. This is our work today, my good boys and girls. This is our work. So please take concern. Don't rush. Go through what you have discussed. You'll be able to pass this work. Thank you very much for watching. We meet again in the next lesson. Thank you.